Hello my dear students, this is A.K. Gupta, your English faculty, Arts High School, Bansur. Now once again welcome back to online classes. We are going to start chapter means this is a poem. So my dear students, this is your first poem, class 8, first poem, The Ant and the Cricket by Aesop's Fable. Aesop's Fable means it is a fables which is a story which has been recited by our parents, grandparents. Okay, so this is called a subscriber. Okay, so my dear students, I know very well that some grammar parts some grammar parts and first chapter has been completed in online classes. Okay, so my dear students, now we are going to complete the first poem and try to understand in simple way. Okay, a fable is a story often with the animals as a character that conveys a moral. My dear students, you know very well any story and any fables which is recited by our grandparents to us for why? Why? Because they want to teach us for doing better in our life. That those stories are moral for us. They want to teach us by those stories that how to survive our life. Okay. This poem about an ant and cricket contains an idea of a far-reaching significance, which is as true of a four-legged cricket as of a two-legged one. Surely you know seen a cricket that has two legs. Here poet tells us two things exactly, which is a real cricket, that is an insect, he has four legs, if you have seen the cricket. Another thing the poet tells us, here is also two-legged cricket, you know, to whom it is signed. It is told us those people, means who all are living on the world. Means it is told us to us, the people, that we are the cricket. Means why we are the cricket told by this story? Because we are doing like them. We are doing like the real cricket. We are following them. We have been created a new thing that we are following to those crickets who are doing like that. We are following and we are doing like that. How the cricket are doing these things? Are you getting? Okay, I would like to tell you in next. Exactly, listen. A silly young cricket accustomed to sing. Accustomed means habitual. Means a silly young cricket has a habit to sing a song daily and every day, and day by day he is going to sing. Through the warm sunny months of gay summer and spring. Means in every weather. It may be warm, sunny, summer, spring, in every weather he has only one work. He has a habit. He is accustomed to sing a song. Begin to complain when he found that at home his cupboard was empty and winter was come. Means when he saw the winter was about to come, the new weather is about to come, that is the winter. And when he looked his cupboard, so there was nothing to eat something. So that time he started to complain, and what was the complaint? Is not a crumb to be found on the snow covered ground. Means there is nothing, even piece of bread, even piece of any grain, even piece of any crumb to be eaten. And now the snow is about to cover, the snow is about to cover the ground. Sorry, covered the ground. Not a flower could he see. There is nothing, even flower. There is nothing, even flower on the tree which can be seen. Not a leaf on tree. So when you know very well the weather, weather means the summer, like winter is about to come. So that time there is no leaf because everywhere is snow. It has been covered with the snow. Oh, what will become, say the cricket, of me? Now. So cricket says, what will be next and what will happen next if I haven't anything? At last by starvation and famine made bold. Now here is starvation means means to be there is nothing to eat something. So and you are going to die without food. That is a starvation. Famine means also that things means there is nothing to survive, there is nothing to eat, there is nothing to wear, and there is nothing to live. Means you don't have anything. Okay, so that is famine. So that time he became bold. Bold means he collected the courage to talk to anyone. And who was the anyone? All dripping with the wet and all trembling with the cold. Means all drip means the water is dripping one by one a drop. Okay, from wet on tree, from tree, from any other things, it was dripping by one drop. Okay, and trembling, he was trembling means like a shivering with the cold. Oh, I'm feeling the cold. Oh my God! So that is shivering with the cold. Away he set off to a miserly ant. It means set off means he come out. Okay, set out. He set off or come out to miserly ant. Miserly ant means he reached to the ant to see if to keep him alive he would grant. He thought, who? Cricket thought, I should go to ant and if I will demand anything to ant, so it may be possible he will give. If ant will give me to shelter to live, food to eat, so I will be survive. Otherwise I will die. Him shelter for rain. If he will provide me shelter, so I can be saved by the rain. I am mouthful grain. He could give me some grain. He wished only to borrow, and he would repay it tomorrow. So Cricket thinks, I would go and I will demand, if you will give me something to eat borrow, so I will give you, I will repay tomorrow. If not, he must die starvation. And so if ant will not provide anything, so definitely Cricket will die starvation. And so sorrow means sad. Says the ant to the Cricket. Now ant says to Cricket, I am your servant and friend. Means I am your servant, I work for you, and I am your friend also. But we ants never give borrow. We ants never lend. Means neither give borrow, neither take lend. Okay? It means neither borrow, neither lend. You can understand. So neither borrow nor lend. You can understand easily. Okay? But tell me, dear Cricket, did you lay nothing by when the weather was warm? Means ant was asking to Cricket, when the weather was so clear, when the weather was warm, so that time why did you not collect your food? Why did you not think about your shelter? Why did you not think to wear those things which can be saved to you by the cold? Quoth means question. The Cricket, note. Cricket replied, not I. Means I know. My heart was so light, means I was so happy, that I sang day and night. When I was happy, so I was singing. I was keep singing day and night. For all nature looked gay, and all nature was looking so beautiful and pleasant. You sang, sir, you sing. So who says? And it means you were singing and you were keep singing those songs day and night, and you did not store anything. Go then, says the ant, and dance the winter away. So ant say, okay, so why are you doing here? What are you doing here? You may go from here and dance and winter away. Means you dance and let the winter away. Okay. Thus ending, he hesitantly lifted the wicket. Wicket means this is a half door, and wicket means we can say a broken door, and a half door and broken door. So he lifted itself and he come out by the wicket door, and out of the door turned the poor little Cricket. That poor little Cricket come outside. Folk means the people call this a fable. Fable means imaginary story which is recited by our grandparents. Our grand warrant it true. Warrant means guarantee. It is I give you guarantee it is true. Some crickets have four legs and some have two. Who is giving guarantee? A grandparents who is reciting the fable, and they are giving us a guarantee. If you will find some people, some animal have four legs and some animal have two legs. Some insects have four legs, some insects have two legs. So two legs is represent to the people who has two legs and living in the world, and they are doing like that. Means they are enjoying their life. If they don't have any type of problem, so they are surviving, they are living and they are enjoying our life. There's nothing problem. But when they have a problem, that time they are thinking, we need help. We need help. I have a very interesting example. You know, the corona pandemic is going on. So in this corona pandemic, who all over stored some food and some rupees, some money, they survived their life 1 or 2 years without any tension and easily. But my dear students, who hadn't stored money or any eatable items, so those people are so in the trouble, and they are suffering from many tensions, and they are suffering from many problems because they don't have to be eaten anything. So exactly the poet says us, you will have to be careful your surviving life. You will have to be careful, like that you are to store some money, and you will have to think about your future, what you are going to do, what you will do in your future. But it does not happen that the time has gone there after you are thinking, what should I do? Okay, my dear, I hope you got it, all these things. So watch it, this video, and let's meet in the next video. Thank you.